So now we'll be doing our final example, delete. Now, there's a few different delete functions we can write. We'll be doing delete at index. So say, for example, we were given a list and a number, for example, 3. We will go to that numbered index, like 3, and delete the third element. Okay, so without further ado, how do we do that? So we need to create a current pointer, which points to the first node. Now, there'll be a few cases we'll have to deal with, but we'll get to them as we go. So we'll have current point to our first node over here, and we'll get it to iterate through until we get to the node before the node we wish to delete. So if we want to delete this node, we'll wait until current gets here. Now, because it's only one node down, we will use a loop, but we only have to execute that loop one time. If there were lots of nodes here, or we were deleting a node with a larger index, we'd have to iterate through quite a few times before we got to the node before the node we wish to delete. So, what's next? We're going to need a temp variable, a temp pointer, to point to some address. It's a bit lenient as to which one we can get it to point to, and I'll explain why we need one. So over here, if we delete this node over here, we're going to lose this pointer, which points to this node. So if we delete this node without storing the address of this node, we're going to lose both of them, and we won't be able to access even this value, which we wish to access. Also, it won't be freed in memory, which is another problem which we'll deal with another time. So, what can we do? Well, the first way we can solve this is we can have a temp pointer point to this node, and then we can get this current next to point to this final node, current next next. Now, then we'll have our list look like this, which is displayed here, and then we'll be able to delete to free the node pointed to by temp. So that would work. The other way we can do it, and the way Callum will do it, is he's going to have a temp pointer point to current next next. So that's this. If current next is this node, then current next next is this node over here. So he's going to set the temp pointer point to this node. Then what he's going to do is he's going to free current next, which is this node. He is then going to set this pointer to point to temp. So like this. We can get rid of this over here. And it'll point round to here. When this is freed, the pointer will also get freed with it. So this whole thing will go, and we'll be left with this. We do not have to concern ourselves with current and temp, because when we return from our function, we're just going to return this first pointer, which is called list or head or whatever you wish to call it when passing it into our function. And we'll have our final list with one less element at the third index. So now we have the case of, if we have an empty list, right? We can straight away just return our list because we don't have to delete anything. So if our list is null, we can either return the list or we can return null because they're the same thing. The next thing is if we want to delete the first node. Now that's a bit tricky because current had to point to the node before the node we wish to delete. But when we use a current pointer, it always points to the first node, which there is no node before the node we wish to delete. So we need a special case. For this, what we could do is we can have a temp point to the first node. So I'm just going to draw it here, might as well. So we'll have temp point to the second node. And then what we'll do is we'll free the list head. We don't have to use current. Current doesn't have to be here. And then what we'll have to do is we'll free the list head, so the first node, and we'll still have this pointer which points to this node and all the subsequent nodes. We'll then return temp, and then we'll have like a list that looks like this, a pointer and these three nodes. And that's exactly what we wanted. So now over to Callum, who will show you how to do this in code.